This how-to video will show you how to prepare the Hamilton S1 ventilator. However, the procedure is exactly the same for a Hamilton G5 ventilator. This educational video does not replace the relevant instructions for use. Be sure to read the ventilator's operator's manual, as well as instructions for use that accompany the humidifier or other devices, breathing circuits, and other consumables. Pay particular attention to important safety and hygiene information. There are a few steps you need to follow before starting ventilation. The whole procedure takes approximately 3 minutes. Make sure the power cable is firmly connected in the socket to prevent accidental disconnection, and then connect it to the primary power outlet. The primary power indicator is solid blue when the ventilator is plugged in and connected to primary power, even when the ventilator is turned off. If the battery is not charging for whatever reason, the indicator will remain dark. Make sure the ventilator is connected to a power source prior to starting ventilation. If you haven't done so already, connect the oxygen and air gas hoses to the ventilator, and then to the gas supply or a gas cylinder. To connect the breathing circuit, do the following. First, install the expiratory valve set. Then, select the appropriate breathing circuit and components. Third, assemble the breathing circuit. Then, connect the external devices and sensors. Finally, perform the pre-operational checks. If you are using a pre-assembled coaxial breathing set, this contains everything you need: the expiratory valve set, the breathing circuit, and the flow sensor. In a single-use expiratory valve set, the membrane is permanently attached to the expiratory valve body. Do not remove, tug, or pull on the membrane. Position the expiratory valve set in the expiratory port and twist it clockwise until it locks into place. To connect the coaxial breathing circuit, first attach the main tube to the inspiratory port and then connect the expandable expiratory tube to the expiratory valve. Finally, attach the blue and clear tubes to the flow sensor connection ports on the ventilator. Always position the flow sensor tubing on top of the flow sensor. If you plan on using a double-limb heated breathing circuit, start by installing the expiratory valve set. The expiratory valve set is delivered clean and ready for use. Always check the set before using it on the patient. Position the expiratory valve set in the expiratory port and twist it clockwise until it locks into place. If you are using an autoclavable expiratory valve set, first assemble it by placing the silicone membrane onto the expiratory valve housing. Ensure that the metal plate is facing upwards, and then proceed with the installation. The procedure is the same as for a single-use component. Install a water bag or bottle above the humidifier. Choose the correct breathing circuit according to the patient group or selected treatment. The following information applies if you are using the Hamilton BC8022 breathing circuit or any other double-limb heated breathing circuit. First, insert the humidifier chamber. Connect the shorter blue tube to the inspiratory port on the ventilator. And then connect the expiratory tube to the expiratory valve. Insert the water feed line into the water bag or bottle. Make sure that all electrical contacts on the breathing circuit match the connecting element on the humidifier. Insert a flow sensor into the breathing circuit in front of the patient connection, that is, the Y piece. Attach the blue and clear tubes to the flow sensor connection ports on the ventilator. To prevent water accumulating in the flow sensor and tubing, position the flow sensor tubing on top of the flow sensor. The gas temperature is measured at the Y-piece by means of the temperature probe integrated in the inspiratory limb. Keep the inspiratory limb positioned correctly. To prevent patient or ventilator contamination, connect a bacterial and viral inspiratory filter between the patient and the inspiratory port. An expiratory filter is not required, but you may use one for infection control, according to your institution's protocol. If you use one, place it on the patient side of the expiratory valve. Monitor closely for increased expiratory circuit resistance. If you use a coaxial breathing circuit, the only filter you need is a heat and moisture exchange filter. Position the filter between the flow sensor and the flex tube, as described in the operator's manual. If you are using a mainstream CO2 sensor, connect the sensor cable at this point to the corresponding connection port. Slide the CO2 sensor onto the airway adapter. Align the arrows on both components and press them together until you hear a click. Then connect the sensor with the airway adapter between the breathing circuit and the flow sensor. Position the breathing circuit in such a way that the tubes will not be pushed, pulled, or kinked if the patient moves. The next step is to perform the pre-operational checks.